Hello, Noah.
Curt, hello. How are ya?
All right. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Happy New Year. Happy 2020.
There we go. We're here. We made it.
That's right. Now, do you have like any resolutions? Do you do all that good stuff? I mean, for myself, I'm just going to have goals set for myself.
Yeah, I think it's more of that. More of goals rather than resolutions. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe to, I don't know, just spread more love. How about that?
Yes.
Yeah,
you That's know. Right, Curt. More love and more kindness. Our world so desperately needs
Amen
that.
Amen to
know?
That, brother.
Mm-hmm. All right, Curt. Well, let's go ahead and get started. So, you know, you were set to host the Ultimate Canine Competition, America's Top Dog, a new series coming to A&E for the new year. So kind of tell us all about it.
Well, you know, it's basically Ninja Warriors for dogs. So if you understand what American Ninja Warriors is, you got it. So it's a dog competition show. Where dogs compete over multiple obstacles on this obstacle course, huge outdoor set. Our executive producer actually did American Ninja Warrior. So she comes from that background, so she knows how to do the sets. And they've got to jump fences, they got to swim through water, they've got to do different scent detections, which obviously humans don't do because they don't have the noses to do it. But it's dogs competing. We start with five dogs each episode. Four of the five are from law enforcement agencies around the country, including one from the popular show Live PD, which a lot of people watch on A&E, and a lot of people will know these dogs already. And so they compete against one civilian underdog, which is just a family pet. I mean, we've had all types. We have pointers, we have a border collies, we've got a shorty bulldog, all these different dogs. But because it's a timed event on an obstacle course, it's really balanced because some dogs are better swimmers than others, or some are better at jumping than others. And so it balances out because it's all against the clock, and they all compete for the title Top Dog each episode, and at the end of the season to find out who America's Top Dog is.
Oh, I love it. And, you know, each week, too, the winning team will receive like $10,000 and an additional $5,000 to donate to the animal charity of their choice, which I think is so great. So to be part of something, you know, that's so extraordinary like this, Curt, how does it really make you feel, you know, because you are the host?
Yeah, no, it's great because I'm a dog lover. I've got two rescue dogs at home. And you mentioned the $10,000 going to the winning team and $5,000 to the animal charity of their choice. And so that could be anything that benefits from this competition that they're not even involved in. And at the end of the season, the winning team gets $25,000 along with the animal charity donation. So there's a huge benefit that goes on. But I think a couple of things. It opens people's eyes, particularly since four of the five dogs are from law enforcement agencies around the country, to one, the fact that a number of police dogs are actually rescues. People don't realize that. They think these dogs are bred, you know, from day one to be a police canine. A number of them are rescue, you know, when they're puppies, obviously, because you still have to train them in order to be police dogs. But I think that opens people's eyes and reminds them that you can go to your local shelter and you can find a dog and you could train that dog, if you're willing to put in the work and the effort, to do anything. And I think the civilian dogs do that as well. But I also am really proud of the fact that it kind of opens people's eyes to, I think there's such a negative stereotype to police dogs in general. And when I say that, I mean it's because people see them always chasing bad guys or trying to, you know, bite a suspect or whatever. And they think that all German Shepherds are like that, or Belgian Malinois, these big fluffy dogs with 20 ears. And some people get nervous around them. But when they get off of work, they're like us. That's how they are at work. These police officers take these dogs home in their free time. The dogs play with their kids. They play with Frisbees in the backyard. And we show some of that personal life. And I think it opens the door to remind people that, you know what, these are just dogs. And they have work mode and they have play mode as well.
Are we going to win?
They're the longest partnership in tonight's competition. But will they be the fastest?
Police canines like Falco are in and out of cars every day, and that translates to lightning speed.
Wow! Onto the fire escape in under 30 seconds.
This tests team communication. Does the dog understand what the handler needs him to do with the ball?
Falco does. He's eating up this course.
Take it.
These dogs are bred to instinctively grab balls, and it shows.
Out of the fire escape in under a minute, but how will tonight's oldest dog handle the high jumps?
Whoa, no hesitation. hesitation.
Oh, pretty.
Oh. Well, Curt, this has been such a pleasure to get to speak with you. America's Top Dog premieres Wednesday, January the 8th, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on A&E Network. Curt, thank you so much. This was a lot of fun, and I will definitely be tuning in with my entire family. I'm going to have my little Maltese dog, Bella.
Okay.
We're going to watch. Yes, she's going to be wanting all the treats, but,
perfect.
You know, we'll be watching.
We'll get her season 2. Thank you, Noah.
Yes. Thank you, Curt. Take care. Have a good one.
You too.